be a thorn in his side. Bad talent to take in a wizard matchup. Thorn's only benefiting against melee damage dealers. Cubsy jumping in right away, but actually gets stunned up by Gorecki. Smexin trying to set up some damage. Lightning Lasso, good punish on Cubsy so far for his overextended position. Maybe they just kill him in the opener if they catch him out totally off guard. Thugonomics gets stalled out. Chanimal now looks to reverse. Cubsy is stabilized. It's Chanimal in the driver's seat with his Infernals activated. Thugonomics may look to retreat, although boldly playing at center field. Feared awkwardly, actually, away from Chanimal. Chanimal would have much preferred Thugonomics feared into the middle of the map. A bit unlucky. Thugonomics now trying to get a bolt. Multiman blinks away from it. Good reaction time there. Cubsy poking Thugonomics. Both Warlocks unable to really get any Chaos Bolts off during their Infernals. Thugonomics sets up with a Fear. He's trying to bait an interrupt on Fear so that he can cast Chaos Bolt. Nether Ward available. Now out of the way. Thugonomics not able to get any Chaos Bolts with his Dark Soul. Chanimal still has his. They're actually attacking Cubsy pretty much every Lightning Lasso. That could be a big opening. Gorecki also being attacked, although less stuns available overall for Cloud9's composition. Perhaps if the boys can continue switching to Cubsy, they will eventually find a kill.
Yeah, out of all the druids in North America right now, I'd have to say Gorecki and Cubsy have been a cut above the rest in terms of their feral affinity gameplay. So I'm interested to see which one of these druids is able to get ahead, get out more damage in the matchup. It's also kind of an interesting dynamic here between Thugonomics and Chanimal. We know Chanimal is one of the best warlocks in the North American region, of course, coming from Australia. And then, of course, you have Thugonomics on the Destruction Warlock, specifically where he has been holding it down for years and years. It feels like we'll have to see which one of them can come out ahead in this matchup.
Ooh, double Mortal Coil from Thugonomics with Lightning Lasso. Big setup attempt, but no damage, unfortunately. Wealthy Man playing at the pillar quite effectively, avoiding a lot of damage. The positioning of Cloud9 is perfect. Smexin and Thugonomics dipping low in this position, but Gorecki is there. He's looking like he wants to stop Cubsy from drinking, though, so he's leaving his team behind to stop Cubsy. Wealthy Man had to exchange some health, but to return full mana, that's more than good. Chanimal now stunned up, bursted by Smexin, but recovering. No real openings right now for either team. Wealthy Man line of sighting immediately after getting bursted by Smexin. Really want to see some coordinated stun locks by the team of the boys. Lightning Lasso, double Mortal Coil, something along these lines. The Mortal Coil Cubsy to set up on him. Big Earth Shock from Smexin. Cubsy needs to be careful. He's spending a lot of time in enemy territory. Decides to use Iron Bark on himself, as he can use Barkskin when he's stunned, and he's anticipating being the target for some time. It's wiser to use the Iron Bark rather than Barkskin at this point. Now he can also be more aggressive with its defense activated. Although having committed that, now it's not available for Wealthy Man, so if Wealthy Man is not careful, he may need to Ice Block. Smexin's having a difficult time just connecting at the moment, though. Gorecki jumping back to the pillar, doesn't want to be out in midfield too long with Chanimal waiting. Cubsy now moving in. Gorecki being smacked by Cubsy. Triple Shadow Fury out from Chanimal. Could be devastating.
Whoa!
Huge pressure. No defense for one more second. Gorecki barely holding on.
Yep, does manage to sneak away at the cost of his Trinket and Iron Bark. Mana relatively even for both druids. Smexin going to be retreating with Gorecki, moving across the map. They've left Thugonomics behind, though. He's caught up in snares, caught up in Novas. Chanimal, can he get any damage out? A beautiful double Mortal Coil comes in. The Unending Resolve traded out as well from Thugonomics. Gets feared up by Chanimal. Good denial on any sort of damage. Didn't want to allow Thugonomics to get full value out of that cooldown, but getting off uninterruptible Chaos Bolt, so Fear was a great choice to really slow that down.
Ooh, Infernals from Chanimal. All three members of the boys in a lot of trouble right now, but they're actually going for a kill on Cubsy. They're very low in health. Can they kill him before they die themselves? They don't get it. Now Cubsy is just smacking him, sitting on top of all three players. And just look at the pressure. This is so unexpected from the Mage Warlock, which you anticipate to win off crowd control, but they're just winning on pressure. Another restyle stun. Everyone in trouble. Gorecki Polymorph fortunately breaks early, able to save Thugonomics as a result. Smexin holding on by a thread. Astral Shift has to be committed on top of basically the entire defensive lineup of the boys. Smexin is still low. Shadow Fury from Chanimal. These are high-value Infernals from Chanimal. It's blowing out the entire defensive lineup of the boys.
Yeah, and all three members of the boys still in a little bit of trouble. Thugonomics, although he has great hit points right now, no defensive cooldowns left to really work with. Thugonomics trying to get some counter pressure here with the Chaos Bolt onto Wealthy Man, but Wealthy Man has just been eating all of these Chaos Bolts with little regard. Has both of his Ice Blocks still available in this match. Smexin getting low in midfield. Cubsy all over him. Is he going to be able to take him down? Big damage, nice grounding totem on that Gladiator's Maledict. Able to soak up that effect. Gorecki finally moving over with a little bit of backup. Mana now, I believe, in favor of Cubsy quite heavily, in fact. So Cloud9 has that advantage moving forward.
Cloud9 looking unstoppable, except for against the Mew Mew Kitty Cats. That is perhaps the only team in the game right now to be able to beat Cloud9, looking at the way that this one is going on the Grand Arena against the boys. Curious to see if they change their composition moving forward, although this may just be their best option. But if this is their best option, they're just getting trounced constantly. All three members low on health, and Gorecki has to expend so much mana healing, he can't get any time to get aggressive in cat form. And then Cubsy further snowballs it. Thuganomics is trying to carry the team in his back pocket by switching to Cubsy on his own. Gets some pressure, but Cubsy doesn't even care. He's just smacking Thuganomics standing in front of him, just kind of bad manner, saying there's no way I'm going down to you, and just continuing to build more momentum for the team. Perhaps maybe a little bit of overconfidence could cost them the game, but when you're at such a lead in terms of cooldowns and mana, I don't really blame Cubsy to just try and maximize his damage at this point.
Yeah, I mean, you really can't blame him. Wealthman still getting a little bit lower. Is he going to have to finally use one of his ice blocks? Honestly, I thought the boys would have more pressure in this matchup, but Cloud9, that has played such a hyper-aggressive strategy that they sort of force their opponents into this very defensive position. Thuganomics has just been running away. Gorecki now getting targeted down. Cubsy once again in his face, just getting out all kinds of pressure, and the boys are falling apart. Beautiful Shadow Fury coming in from Chanimal. Thuganomics sees a big Chaos Bolt, trying to get out of line of sight, but he cannot run away from Cubsy. Unending Resolve gets traded out. They need counter pressure, and they need it now, but they're not going to be able to find it. Infernal Stun into a Shadow Fury. Thuganomics barely holding on, but Gorecki gets interrupted. Cloud9 walking all over the boys, and I did not expect this matchup to play out this way.
Two in North America, and Cloud9, number one in North America, will be going head-to-head to eliminate each other so early on in the first cup of the summer season. Tournament lives on the line, and most importantly, maybe potentially a point-earning spot at BlizzCon on the line if the boys are eliminated so soon. Method Orange have a big opportunity. Pressure on Chun-Li right off the bat.
Yeah, Chun-Li under fire in Immortal Coil. Gorecki looking to deflect that with the Iron Bark. Nice double leg sweep coming in from Chun-Li, getting some pressure rolling for his team. What is Thuganomics going to be able to do? In the last game, he got bullied quite a bit by Wealthy Man, by Chanimal. Wasn't able to get out as many Chaos Bolts, as much damage as we normally see. But now with Chun-Li moving in, soaking up some of that damage, soaking up some of that, you know, disables that Chanimal and Wealthy Man really are going to be able to put out in this matchup. It will free up Thuganomics quite a bit. Let's have to see how much damage he really can get out.
Wealthy Man falling a bit behind here. Chun-Li carrying the team, going for a touch of death. So they need to crowd control Chun-Li or trade a cooldown. Iron Bark, they're relying on that for now. It may not be enough. That was a huge hit. Baldy Man's going to ice block at the same time. So a bit of an overlap, but a high value play from Chun-Li.
Yeah, Chun-Li doing some good work. But Thuganomics, these massive Chaos Bolts are what ultimately forced out that first ice block from Wealthy Man. And already, 30 seconds into this game, they were able to accomplish more than we saw with the Elemental Shaman of Smexen. So good pressure initially for the boys. The smaller map certainly helps. That's why they brought in Chun-Li on the smaller map. His uptime is going to be much higher than what you'd see on Tolvaron or in a Grand Arena. So I think it was an intelligent decision to bring in this composition on this particular map. And it has banked them an ice block very early on from Wealthy Man, but they have to actually close out the game. It's not enough to just get one ice block. Cloud9 has been playing a lot more passively. I think with the positioning the boys have taken, sort of this triangle formation where Thuganomics is at one pillar, you have Gorecki at one pillar, and Chun-Li in the midfield, they're not going to be able to do that same strategy where they sort of just overrun their opponents with mass, you know, AoE damage with the Frozen Aura of the Blizzard. Chanimals moves in with the double Mortal Coil. It's going to be a little bit different in this particular game. So I think the boys with the positioning have been doing a fantastic job so far.
I will say Chun-Li has credited whenever he's playing on the roster, why'd you pick this roster? And he says just because he likes playing with Thuganomics. So I think it was wise for them to pair up together here for game number two after such a poor showing in game number one with their Elemental Shaman Destruction Warlock. Like you said, they've already gotten more done in the first minute of the game than they did in the entirety of the last one. Now switching targets to Chanimal, trying to throw Cubsy for a loop, maybe expend more heal over time effects, maybe just get a kill. Chanimal in quite a bit of trouble in midfield. Cubsy being pressured by Gorecki, so Cubsy decides to abandon that position, gate across, recover on the opposing side, but his mana is significantly behind. Strategy and map selection perfect from the boys. Synergy looking solid as well between Chun-Li and Thuganomics. Pressure continues to mount in their favor.
Yeah, Thugonomics has been a turret in this game. He took the initial pillar, got out a lot of damage. Now he's taken over the team of Cloud9 pillar, and he just hasn't really been moving from these spots. Look at him, he's just spamming out Chaos Bolts. Wealthy Man forced to run away. Chanimal in midfield. Chun-Li actually chasing Wealthy Man down. Wants to get out that second ice block if he can. I'm not sure he's going to be able to solo it out with Cubsy right there. But Chun-Li just throwing over a touch of death on Cubsy. Wants to really get this pressure rolling on all three members. And you can tell the boys on this composition, they are a lot more comfortable. They're all over the place, sort of freestyling in this matchup. In the last game, we did not see that kind of confidence.
Yeah, we definitely didn't. They're looking solid to take game two here, tie it up to lower bracket. Both the teams face elimination, which is still so surprising this early on in the tournament. Cubsy is in stealth. He's sneaking around the map and trying to drink. The boys need to find where he is as soon as possible and stop it. Greki knows where he is, and he's trying to get there, but Wealthy Man is slowing him down. How much mana did Cubsy ultimately get from that exchange? Perhaps some, but I don't think nearly enough to really win the game off of. He's still significantly behind. Wealthy Man getting Chaos Bolted by Thugonomics. Chanimal trying to Chaos Bolt Chun-Li off. He actually uses Touch of Karma just to redirect damage and stay on target. Wealthy Man's forced to polymorph Chun-Li desperately to recover, but damage is still mounting in favor of the boys. Cubsy has to make a decision to Iron Bark. He chooses not to, but now he's crowd controlled. Wealthy Man's trying to just avoid damage on the outskirts of the map and line of sight Thugonomics in this position, and he should be able to. Cubsy slowly but surely recovering. Greki with Thugonomics at the pillar. Greki a little bit reluctant to push out and try and get any damage going. Now jumping and crowd controlling Cubsy. If he can get anything out of the bash, perhaps not able to in this position, unfortunately. So the crowd control chain is lost. Wealthy Man should recover. It's Greki now who could be in trouble. Infernals have landed. How are they going to get something done here? Thugonomics is trying to Chaos Bolt Chanimal, I could only imagine. Maybe Wealthy Man. Wealthy Man blinking out of line of sight. Now Chanimal looking to reverse. So both Warlocks have activated their most powerful cooldown. They're going to be the most threatening that they can be in the matchup at this moment in time. But Chanimal is the one who is on the back foot.
Yeah, Chanimal having to play a little bit of a line of sight game right now. Thugonomics not able to get out too much damage. It's been good control from Wealthy Man. If we look at mana, Cubsy is way behind in this matchup. If they can just deny those drinks coming in from Cubsy, the boys can secure a massive lead on this map. Whereas Greki, look at him, he has so much freedom with this position. You just sit down, he's going straight to full mana. Cubsy on 10%. The boys in a commanding lead at this point in terms of cooldowns as well as mana. Wealthy Man getting a little bit low as well. He got interrupted on Frost. He has to hold on a little bit longer. Can Chun-Li force out the ice block? Thugonomics gets interrupted by Chanimal. Good backup. Wealthy Man is able to hold on to that second ice block. Cold Snap almost available, so he'll have three ice blocks moving forward. Cubsy still not an opportunity to get away quite yet in this game, but he doesn't seem too concerned. He's still playing really aggressive, moving in cat form, trying to generate some damage for his team. Now finally repositioning, and this could be the moment, the defining moment in this game where Cloud9 tries to get back in by allowing Cubsy to get some mana.
All right, Chanimal trying to save Wealthy Man as he was stunned up by Greki. Greki sees Cubsy sneaking away, and he's trying to stop him. Will he be able to find him is the question. How much mana did he get? Cubsy got at least just a bit to keep this fight going on into dampening. Wealthy Man has survived to the point where that first ice block is now no longer relevant. He will have two for the remainder of the match at this point in time. Greki still with a significant mana lead. I can't help but feel that these swaps to Cubsy haven't really been paying off. Perhaps if Chun-Li had just been staying on target, Wealthy Man would have already been dead at this point. They still want to go onto the Druid. They're trying to kill Cubsy, but Chanimal is there to deny. Perfect triple Shadow Fury, stalling damage and allowing Cubsy to slip away to safety. Chun-Li and Thugonomics now on the back foot. Chaos Bolt's flying in from Chanimal. But Thugonomics ducks around the corner. Chun-Li sees Cubsy sneaking away. Greki does as well, but Greki gets snared up on his way to Cubsy. Greki needs to stop him. He moonfires him, keeps him in combat, stops the drink. Wealthy Man in a bit of trouble. Ring of Peace back into Chun-Li's clutches. Ice block forced. Momentum continuing to carry in favor of the boys. It's looking better and better. I'm trying to see any opportunities for Cloud9, and there really aren't any at this point.
Yeah, this is surprising. I feel like this is a matchup we've seen before, but it definitely go this way. It definitely did not go this way. The boys, lots of pressure, lots of momentum. Wealthy Man, of course, does have that third ice block that has rotated back up. Cold Snap has come off cooldown. He was able to use it. Now he has one more available. Touch of Death is rolling for Chun-Li with the Fortifying Brew. Big damage on Wealthy Man. What's he going to do? He gets stunned. Another ice block forced out. And now Cloud9 in position where Wealthy Man, he does not have another ice block for another 4 minutes. There is a huge window of opportunity. You can see Thugonomics. He has the Infernals. He has the Dark Skull. He has all the tools he needs to close out this game. Are they going to be able to do it? Are they going to be able to tie up this series?
They have to kill Gorecki. He used his Glider's Medallion, pop Infernals, pop Icy Veins, and kill Gorecki. That's all you can do. And as long as Gorecki doesn't put himself in a position where that's possible, then the boys have Cloud9 in checkmate. They've run them out of mana. They've run the mage out of cooldowns. They just need to stay on target. Right now, they're actually attacking Chanimal. I mean, they get unending resolve, but I feel like, can't help but feel the attack would have been better onto Wealthy Man. Perhaps Wealthy Man is just making it too difficult to attack him at that moment in time. Although the boys' positioning is starting to be compromised, they're standing too close to each other, and you can already see the damage sinking into three members. They should definitely focus on spreading out a bit, maintaining their position. They're trying to go for the all-in on Gorecki. This is their only chance. They have to kill him 100-0. If they can do it, they're going to win, but if they can't, they're going to lose. Seconds away from being able to finish him off. They have to take him down. They don't do it.
Wealthy
he
man.
Survives, and now Wealthy Man in a lot of trouble. Chaos Bolt's flying over. Wealthy Man in desperation to hold out. Manages to hold on for now. Cloud9 don't get the kill. If perhaps they can stay alive, they could get one more swing at Gorecki, but it's not going to pack that much punch.
What a tense moment for both teams. Wealthy Man was just caught in a stun. He wanted to get out just a little bit more damage, but Chun-Li denied him with a nice leg sweep, and as a result, Gorecki does manage to survive, and the boys managed to stay ahead. As we were saying, that was the one opportunity, one shot that Cloud9 really had to take down Gorecki and take down the boys. Now I'm not sure where their opening is, really. They committed a lot to that offense. Wealthy Man still no ice block for another 3 minutes. Boys have Touch of Death rolling up. There's a lot of damage available with that cooldown. And if they can do it, they might be able to take Wealthy Man down. But in the meantime, Cubsy actually getting swapped to. Touch of Death committed. Rake Stun comes in. Big damage. Cubsy trying to survive. But good night, Chun-Li with the leg sweep to Touch of Death. Does manage to secure the kill and tie up the series. And that matchup actually looked really good for the boys, but I can't help but feel it was just because of that smaller map.
Yeah, I mean, potentially it's the map, but either way, the
on Arena, this is certainly going to be their worst map, but if they can find victory here, I mean, this is going to be looking very good for the boys, as I don't really think Cloud9 has a better answer to this composition.
On this map, it's going to be a lot more difficult for Chun-Li. He was kind of the MVP for the boys, setting up all the kills and all the opportunities. But if he is pulled into a bad position, and Tolvaren has a lot of those, he could easily become the greatest strength, or go from the greatest strength to the greatest weakness of the team on Tolvaren, which means that Cloud9 would move to match point and eliminate the boys from the tournament. And that then gives Method Orange an opportunity to catch them in points and possibly steal away their qualification to BlizzCon.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely what Cloud9 is going to go after in this matchup. I want to still have a really great showing in this tournament. Obviously, I mean, they've already qualified to BlizzCon based off their performance in the spring finals. They were able to get the first place finish, and they are the team to beat right now. The boys definitely have their work cut out for them. What is Chun-Li, Gorecki, and Thugonomics going to be able to get done here in game number three is the question. Chun-Li putting some pressure over on the Chanimal. We saw in game number two, the sort of bounce between all three targets. They were able to get three ice blocks from Wealthy Man, lots of damage over on the Chanimal, including getting out against Unending Resolve. Ultimately, it was Cubsy that fell on a big swap, so the boys have a lot of options in this matchup, kind of just going after whoever Thugonomics can get that damage off. You can see him positioned very far away, just acting as sort of a turret for his team, spamming out the Incinerate, spamming out the Chaos Bolts, really just trying to find some damage.
Yeah, they've got Chun-Li positioned at the entrance to the starting room. Curious if they drag him any further into the corner or not. Currently happy to have him here, I suppose. Chanimal getting switched to by Chun-Li. Doesn't want to overextend too much. Decent pressure so far on the Chanimal, but no significant mana advantage just yet. Nether Ward from Chanimal sending that Chaos Bolt right back at Thugonomics. Good timing by both Warlocks in this matchup with their Nether Wards hitting some very powerful spells with them. Thugonomics smartly banishing the Fell Hunter, Chanimal as well. So if the Fell Hunter, the demonic pet of the Warlock, is banished or crowd controlled, it cannot use Spell Lock, which can interrupt Chaos Bolts. So both of the Warlocks are frequently looking to banish the Fell Hunters, then cast their most important spells. So you either interrupt that banish, which then later you can't stop Chaos Bolt, or if you don't interrupt the banish, you can cast Chaos Bolt. So the highest level of play from the Warlocks, as would be expected between veterans, BlizzCon champion Chanimal, and veterans like Thugonomics, of course, here in the match. Up, it's still so surprising to see them in the lower bracket facing elimination against each other.
Yeah, it definitely is. Chun-Li and Wealthy Man in midfield right now, trying to get some damage rolling. Wealthy Man blinks away, trying to overextend Chun-Li. That's the main vulnerability for the boys, is the fact that Chun-Li is on the Windwalker Monk. If he gets dragged into an unideal position, they can take advantage of that. Chun-Li Wealthy Man can get out a lot of consistent damage. On this map also, it's going to be a lot easier for Cubsy to sneak away, get drinks, recover his mana, and that's something that definitely came into play in game number two.
Multi-man is under a bit of pressure. Surprising to not see Ironbark committed during that assault. Crowd control alone should be enough. Chun-Li switches targets. Thugonomics backs him up. Chaos Bolt flies in, connects to Chanimal. Gorecki's crossing midfield, looking like he wants to push onto Cubsy for crowd control. Believe Cubsy sees him. He's trying to avoid him. Will he be able to land the stun lock? Cubsy gets paralysis. That sets up Gorecki to move in. Gets the bash for follow-up, but Chun-Li can't connect. He's crowd controlled far too much. Can't do any damage with that little attempt onto Cubsy. Chun-Li getting Frostnova'd instantly on his Flying Serpent kick. He's then going to just switch targets to Wealthy Man, start flying out some Fist of Fury. Gorecki has given up his aggressive positioning, going back to the pillar with Thugonomics, not wanting to get swapped to. Obviously, likely tracking the Infernos of Thugonomics whenever those are available. Gorecki is always positioned in the best place to survive, as that is definitely a win condition for Cloud9 on this map. If they can get Gorecki in a good spot, blow him up in a stun lock. So Gorecki's going to be waiting patiently for Chanimal to commit those Infernos before making a move. Although, as I say that, maybe looking across, Cloud9, are, they've just got them in a position where they have to push forward. So the boys move in as a unit together, trying to collapse onto Wealthy Man. Gorecki needs to slip around the corners and avoid being stacked up with his team at all costs. Infernal's not called in just yet. Both Warlocks playing it patiently.
Yeah, both Warlocks holding on to the defensive cooldowns. Chanimal, Cubsy positioned at the pillar right now. Thugonomics, Gorecki as well. Sort of a mirror match. Wealthy Man in the open with Chun-Li, but Chun-Li's just getting caught into a lot of crowd control. Big burst setup here on Gorecki. And it's a bash into the Mortal Coil. What is he going to be able to do? Does manage to escape. Beautiful spell lock coming in from Thugonomics. Great backup from that Destruction Warlock, keeping Gorecki alive. He really didn't have to use too many cooldowns there. Gorecki moving in, gets the bash done over onto Cubsy. Gorecki now throwing over his Gladiator's Mallet to come to Cubsy as well. This is a bit of an interesting choice. Cubsy does manage to just Shadow Meld it and get away. Now, across the map, he's going to be looking to recover his precious mana. And knowing that, Chun-Li, he wants to get aggressive on Chanimal, punish Cubsy. They might be able to get the unending resolve. They do. They might be able to get more. If they can get crowd control on Cubsy, Chanimal could easily fall.
Yeah, at any moment here, unending resolve is over. Infernals have landed for both sides. Ironbark needs to be enough, but the question is, will it be enough? Chanimal holds out, now goes for a double Mortal Coil of his own, looking to set up and ramp for some big Chaos Bolts himself. Chun-Li looking to be the target right now, at least for Wealthy Man. Chaos Bolt casted, connects. Touch of Karma, though, instantly by Chun-Li on its damage effect, redirecting the damage back to Chanimal. Chun-Li then switching targets again to Wealthy Man. Gorecki is backing him up, adding some Feral Affinity pressure to try and force an Ice Block. It's looking good to get it. Swiftman denies it for now. It's actually unbelievable. They're not able to get an Ice Block from Wealthy Man. Chanimal still remains a pretty decent target as they got Unending Resolve. Cubsy traded that cooldown on Chanimal to drink and regenerate full mana. So at least they did get a cooldown for the drink of Cubsy. Chun-Li needs to be careful with no Touch of Karma, although Diffuse Magic is very potent in this specific matchup. Chanimal looking for some Chaos Bolts, using Nether Ward to avoid being spell locked, although not really able to get too much damage off the back of it. Thugonomics being interrupted by Wealthy Man. Wealthy Man knows he's in a bit of trouble here out in the midfield, so using his interrupt to stop damage is a high priority. Cubsy sitting down for a drink in the back line, as you can see him there, trying to avoid the Ring of Peace, but inevitably crowd controlled. Chanimal knows that he's the most vulnerable target. He repositions to the pillar to line of sight Thugonomics. Chun-Li will be the only member to attack him. If Thugonomics pushes forward, he's actually going to go for it. Uses the Demonic Gateway to close the gap and potentially close out game number three here. Try and put Cloud9 on match point. But Cubsy is there to block it.
Yeah, Cubsy's going to be blocking that. He's across the map right now, looking to recover his mana once again. And you can see Wealthy Man midfield, Chanimal midfield as well. They're going to be able to deny Chun-Li and Gorecki from really swapping it up. Big Chaos Bolts coming in from Thugonomics, forcing Wealthy Man to run away once again. They're playing a very defensive playstyle right now. I really feel like what they want to do is just limit Thugonomics. Thugonomics in the last game was able to get out way too much damage with those Chaos Bolts. So if Wealthy Man and Chanimal, they can just focus the spell lock, focus the counter spell on the denial from Thugonomics while just putting a lot of crowd control on Chun-Li. They can limit Chun-Li's damage. also keep Thugonomics as sort of a sitting duck in this matchup. Uh-oh. But the boys, they're trying to capitalize on that. They're going to be going after Chanimal, who is overextended in this position. Cubsy very far away, does manage to top off Chanimal. Wealthy Man still just acting like a turret for his team, looking to get very aggressive as Cubsy once again looking to get out of combat, looking to get in cat form, sip on that water, recover that mana. That's going to put them in a great spot as we move towards 20% dampening.
Yeah, it definitely is. Having full mana at this deep of dampening, very important for the Restoration Druids in a matchup like this. Wealthy Man needs to be a bit careful. He's out in midfield, and they're all three members are teeing off. There's no Iron Bark for a couple of seconds. Big heal from Cubsy, relying on those nourishes, trusting the casted heals. Holds onto his ice blocks for a later time. Curious to see where this ends up overwhelming. Who's going to overstep their bounds? Because at any moment, if you overextend, you're going to expose yourself to those Destruction Warlocks, Chaos Bolts, and the game could close in a matter of seconds. Thugonomics interrupted, stuck in midfield. He's the target right now for Cloud9. Grecki knows that, activates Iron Bark and saves him. Cloud9 see the defensive Iron Bark and switch targets, attacking Chun-Li, looking to get two cooldowns for one push, and they do manage to get Touch of Karma, so this is a nice attack by Cloud9. It sets them up with multiple targets to go after in the future.
Yep, Chun-Li very vulnerable now without that Touch of Karma, but he has the Diffused Magic. And the Fortifying Brune, he has his portal in a good position. So at any point, he could use the Transcendence to escape battle. Wealthy Man with his Icy Veins looking to get Omega aggressive right now onto Chun-Li, putting out big burst damage. Fist of Fury being channeled out on Wealthy Man as he kites away. Chanimal really tearing into Chun-Li right now on 50% health. He has to be a little bit scared. Fortifying Brew might be enough to keep him alive, but Chun-Li on the melee, he's very vulnerable in this situation. Chanimal into a leg sweep. Are they going to be able to get the damage rolling on him? Thugonomics just into Polymorph. Good denial there by Wealthy Man on that setup.
Yep, good denial once again from Cloud9, playing out the map very effectively, and they have the swing match advantage. So even if the boys bring game four to a small map and find victory, Cloud9 can just bring it to Ashe Mains and close the series out. So the boys need a good answer if they can't pull this off here on Tolvron. This composition may not work for them. They're falling behind in pretty much every regard at this point. Infernals available for each war. Warlock. These Infernals likely to be the last set in the match, maybe not even necessary. Thugonomics is just blown out, overstepping for even 1 centimeter and falling into the pressure of Cloud9, who now put the
qualification on reset, and one of these teams will not be making it to the top four in this first cup.
That would be devastating for either team, but of course, pressure in favor now of Cloud9 on match point, but the boys smartly so, bringing it to a small map. I would say maybe the major weakness for the boys' composition on a small map would be Gurecki. He can definitely be swapped to and bursted down. We've seen Cloud9 do that time and time again. I would like to see them employ that strategy facing this composition on Dalaran Sewers. Perhaps, though, they can use the bottom part of the map on the outskirts of the square to kite away from Chun-Li and create big gaps and play a similar style to what they just did on Tolvaron. It looks like the boys are actually going for the aggressive strategy, trying to go after Cubsy right off the bat, bursting him down to half, trying to jump to safety, manages to recover. Good recovery on Cubsy's part, not overextending any significant defensive cooldowns to the initial assault of the boys.
Yep, good start here. There's a double shadow here onto Gurecki, onto Thugonomics. Channel under fire once again. And on the smaller map, we kind of talked about the Windwalker Monk of Chun-Li is going to be able to get up significantly more pressure. Chanimal just in the face of the boys right now, in the face of danger, drops down his Infernals, looking to get some damage rolling. Well, it's Man Cubsy, positioned very far away. The last game we saw Thugonomics fall. Is he going to be the main pressure point once again? Initially, they were going after Chun-Li, but I think they've realized it's better just put control onto the Windwalker Monk. Such a durable target with the low cooldown Fortifying Brew, Diffuse Magic, and Touch of Karma that maybe not the best idea to be consistently going after him, try to limit his damage a little bit more, and then go after Thugonomics. Spam those interrupts out onto his Chaos Bolts, keep him in stun locks, and try to take him down. But that requires a little bit more dampening, unless I can get a really good crowd control chain onto Gurecki. Chun-Li now into a fear. Thugonomics still the main target of choice. Gurecki positioned in cat form right now, moving forward, getting the bash over onto Wealthy Man. Thugonomics lands a big Chaos Bolt. Is he going to be able to land another? Chun-Li getting out of line of sight from any sort of fears from Chanimal with that Fist of Fury. That was really good positioning to get us some damage, but unfortunately, there's just too much healing from Cubsy, and Wealthy Man easily gets topped off.
Good recovery again by Cloud9. They've got good pressure right now as well onto the boys. The boys need to work on splitting up. If they stack up for even a moment, they get cleaved down by Cloud9's damage. So positioning being compromised could be an opportunity for Cloud9 to close the series out. And once again, the boys, they're technically number one point standings because Cloud9 has already qualified. Their points are sort of irrelevant overall for the North American teams. So the boys can't afford to lose this early on when their main competition, Method Orange, is in the upper bracket and looking pretty good to potentially take the whole tournament. So Method Orange could pass the boys in points in the summer season if they don't have a good performance here in the first Summer Cup. Thugonomics low on health on match points. Let's see if Gorecki cracks under the pressure. Nope, recovering quite effectively.
Yeah, quite easily. Thugonomics gets topped off, and these Destruction Warlocks paired with the Restoration Druids are just really durable targets. It's going to take a little bit more than that amount of damage to take him down. Although he gets taken down to around 50% health, 60% health, the Restoration Druid just has so much single target healing, you can easily top him off. They need the crowd control if they really want to take him down. Thugonomics getting feared up. Good control from Chanimal. Wealthy Man now the main target of choice. Chun-Li putting out lots of pressure. Cubsy moves forward, gets the bash actually onto Thugonomics, denying a lot of that incoming damage. Chun-Li finally back on target onto Wealthy Man. Can they force out the first ice block? Counter Chaos Bolts coming in from Chanimal. Both teams putting out massive pressure. If we look at mana, Cubsy and Cloud9, they are a little bit behind, but Cubsy hasn't had the most difficult time so far in these matchups, really recovering his mana. Maybe on this smaller map, as long as Gorecki is paying attention, they can try to deny that drink and develop a mana lead.
It could be one way for them to develop a mana lead, most certainly. But, I mean, it should be so simple on the small map to stop Cubsy from drinking. I really don't think he should ever get one, although he is right now. Gorecki's trying to stop him. Jumping across the battlefield, looking to find him. I don't think that he did, though. Cubsy's in the kitty corner, and I believe got full mana. Well done on Cloud9's part. So long as Wealthy Man doesn't need to block, that gives them an advantage.
Yeah, Wealthy Man in a good position right now, avoiding a lot of damage. Paralysis over on the Cubsy. Chun-Li looking to get aggressive, but they just can't find the damage. Chanimal always there to back him up with the Fear Spam. Leg Sweep comes in. Chanimal with the Counter Fear. Finally, a little bit of damage rolling onto Wealthy Man. Gets the Fist of Fury out. Thugonomics lands the Shadow Fury as well, just trying to get in position, but one strategy adaptation I'm seeing out of Cloud9 is they're limiting Thugonomics damage way more. When we saw in game number two, he was just posted up at a pillar, able to get out significant amounts of Chaos Bolts, of Fears, but so far in this matchup, it's been a little bit of a different story. Wealthy Man has just been kind of snaring him up, moving out of line of sight. When he finally is in line of sight, he gets Mortal Coil, he gets Spell Lock, and I think that damage denial on Thugonomics is a key strategy change we're seeing out of Cloud9.
Yeah, it is a key strategy indeed. Dampening has now just started between the teams and will inevitably close the match out as it reduces incoming healing on all members in the match, certainly to a point where it could reach 100%. The way that this game is going, we may have a dampening record broken unless one of the teams decides to go for an aggressive push soon. Cloud9 still, though, are on match points, so it's up to the boys to be able to pull off a victory. There's much more pressure against them at the moment, and because they weren't able to stop Cubsy from drinking, they're at a disadvantage. They try and set up a swap. They try and set up the miracle kill on the Cubsy, but he is able to wild charge to Wealthy Man, who saves him with a polymorph on Chun-Li. Once again, great support on the side of Cloud9. Yeah.
Good support. Cubsy in a good position to also get away and try to recover some of his mana. Rake stun now onto Chanimal. He's actually overextended quite a bit. Drops out the Infernal. He wants to get counter pressure. This is an intelligent decision. So Chanimal, he drops out his Infernals when he's under fire, but he's still low. There's great pressure coming in from Chun-Li and Thugonomics. Cubsy may have sat down for too much of a drink. Ultimately does recover all of his mana. If he can recover Chanimal, obviously it's going to be worth it, and he does manage to do so. That was a risky play, but pays off for Cloud9. That 9% dampening, this is where you want to start having full mana as the game goes on. It's much more difficult to sit down for a drink as you have to spend a lot more time healing up your teammates. Double Mortal Coil coming in from Chanimal onto Chun-Li and Gorecki. Good counter pressure right now. Chun-Li does manage to shrug a lot of that off with the Fortifying Brew. His portal's in a good position too. That Transcendence location. At any time, you can use Transcendence to portal away to safety of those boxes. Gorecki now getting stunned up. Big all-in attempt here from the team of Cloud9, but unfortunately, Wealthy Man and Chanimal weren't there to really follow up the damage. The Ring of Peace keeping Wealthy Man locked down into the fight. Thugonomics teeing off with the Chaos Bolt. Wealthy Man getting a little bit low, but he still has both of his ice blocks, and Wealthy Man has been able to hold on to these crucial defensive cooldowns consistently throughout this game. If we look at mana, Gorecki's still doing a great job at around 80% mana. Cubsy falling even more behind, even though he was able to recover so much of his mana through that drink just a short while ago. there's been so much significant pressure from the boys that they've been really taxing his mana.
Although I think that it's mostly due to the Mortal Strike effect that the Windwalker Monk brings into the arena that Cloud9 don't have at their disposal. Cloud9, of course, bringing a lot more crowd control to their advantage, so perhaps if they can isolate a target long enough, they could find victory. Chanimal in trouble. The boys looking to take this to game five. Chun-Li going for the kill. He knocks Chanimal off the side. Cubsy gets crowd control. Chun-Li single-handedly making the push. Can he finally get the kill onto Chanimal? Now at 18% dampening, stunning two targets. Big positioning mistake by Cloud9, but Ultiman again trying to take control of Chun-Li. The Polymers are going to be more than enough. He stabilizes. Thugonomics now being targeted down. It's Gorecki who needs to look to recover, although looks to be easily doing so as both teams are playing in the efflorescences of each other's druids. A lot of effective healing from that with the Spring Blossom's talent. Mana actually in favor of Cubsy, so I mean there's actually a good chance that Cloud9 can just close this out soon if the boys don't do something.
Yeah, Thugonomics repositioning behind the pillar. Gorecki going for a drink. What is Chanimal going to be able to get done? Wealthy Man caught in some damage here. Decent counter pressure coming in from Chanimal. He's trying to back up Wealthy Man in the situation. Gorecki moving forward. Finally landing some heals. Big Chaos Bolt on Chun-Li. It's a bit of a scary moment. Fortifying Brew gets traded out, overlapped with the Iron Bark, and both of those damage reductions together are going to make Chun-Li just such a tank in this matchup. But once those fade, not going to have those crucial defensives. Chun-Li going to be a little bit vulnerable here. Thugonomics repositioning to a good spot, trying to get some damage rolling on Chanimal. Chanimal trying to reposition even further away. Does manage to do so. Chun-Li gets Vortex back, has to activate the Diffuse Magic. Gorecki uses a lot of mana to top him off as well, but now the boys can finally start getting some pressure rolling.
Now the boys can look to push for victory and take this to a game number five and keep their tournament lives here. They face elimination, but pressure is actually snowballing a bit in favor of Cloud9. Three members softened up, and Cloud9 could go after any of them at this point. Infernals just ready and waiting. Perhaps the end of the game, perhaps the last set of Infernals. Both Chaos Bolts being casted onto both Chun-Li and Wealthy Man. Chun-Li deciding to switch targets to Chanimal, pull away from the fight, but the more they pull away and stack up, the more damage all three members will take. This is a critical error to stack up on that point.
No.
And Chanimal is shutting it down. Big punish from Chanimal. He looks to close. Gorecki gets bashed up. Thugonomics looks to reverse, but his team is under so much pressure. Chun-Li is trying to sneak a kill in despite his team being basically dead. Can Chun-Li sneak the kill on Chanimal before Thugonomics falls? Chanimal recovers. Both teams recover in this position. Close call.
That was a panic moment for Wealthy Man. Thugonomics was so low on hit points, but Thugonomics just counter-pressured beautifully with his Infernals, with his Dark Soul, was going to eventually take down Chanimal with those Chaos Bolts. Wealthy Man had basically had no choice but to spam out Polymorphs. It would have been way too risky. And now Wealthy Man, he's actually traded out the Ice Block. Things are looking better and better for the boys. Cloud9, of course, does have a little bit of a mana lead. Thugonomics has really no defensive cooldowns left. Neither does Chun-Li while he has the Diffuse Magic. So Chun-Li is actually doing quite well. But Thugonomics, a vulnerable target with no ending resolve for quite some time and 34% dampening. This is when we're going to see Cloud9 really start focusing on just interrupting Thugonomics, making him a vulnerable target, keeping the snares up on him, and just basically he's going to be a sitting duck that Wealthy Man and Chanimal can tee off on.
Yeah, he definitely will be. And at this point, I mean, you've got still one more Ice Block. You've got full mana. If you're Cloud9, you're actually pretty comfortable here on match point in this situation, which I was expecting to be one-sided in favor of the boys. So this is definitely a commanding position. Now reaching 40% dampening. And once again, stacking up for Chanimal to punish. Chanimal taking advantage of this poor positioning time and time again, softening three targets up, potentially for a big push. Thugonomics is taking the brunt of it. He's still choosing to just stand out in the open. Needs to be careful. Might want to look to line of sight. Trying to toss out some Chaos Bolts and kill Chanimal. Sneak in a kill.
Ooh.
Maybe they can get it here. They use Iron Bark to stabilize. Wealthy Man is soloing Thugonomics. Gorecki struggling.
Yeah, keep in mind, Thugonomics is actually using the Honor Talent to empower his Chaos Bolt. When it does land, it drops a little green pool on the ground. That is a massive healing reduction effect. I think it's a 50% reduced healing, so you have to be very careful. If Chun-Li can keep someone locked down with that, it's going to be massive healing reduction, but Thugonomics is the one that's in trouble. Double Mortal Coil comes in. Thugonomics with no defense left. Gorecki does manage to get the Iron Bark, but it's not enough.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.